everyone. Let us try to understand the question related to oblique collision. How to deal with oblique collision? So work, energy, power. And here you will have to use vector, because in collision always I said you will have to use conservation of linear momentum, and linear momentum is a vector quantity, so you must use vector representation. Then the confusion will be reduced. So that here one ball M1 moving with a speed u takes oblique collision with another mass M2 which is at rest. So u1 is u. Now after the collision what happens? They move in different directions. Oblique collision. Let's take this is like alpha, this is like beta, M1, M2, and the velocities are, let's take V1, V2. See, they are not moving along the same direction after the collision. So that's why you cannot add them, you cannot subtract them. I mean velocities or linear momentum. You must take vector representation. But you don't know which direction it is. But you know this is x direction, this is y direction. So that divide the velocity components along x and y. Like this is V2 cos beta and this is V2 sin beta. For this one V1 cos alpha and this one V1 sin alpha. Now after dividing, take initial linear momentum along x equated to final linear momentum along x. Initially M2 is at rest. Only M1 was moving along x axis. So M1 into u. Then finally M1 is moving with V1 cos alpha, M2 is moving with V2 cos beta along X, not Y. So that M1 V1 cos alpha plus M2 V2 cos beta. This is one equation. Then along Y direction, initial linear momentum should be equal to final linear momentum. Now initial linear momentum along Y, zero. No particle was moving along Y. Only particle was moving is M1, that too along X. So finally if you consider, M1 is moving up with V1 sin alpha. But M2 is having downward, so minus. Because opposite direction. So one is positive means other is negative. So that here you will get M2 V2 sin beta equal to M1 V1 sin alpha. So this way you have to apply the conservation of linear momentum for x direction separately, for y direction separately, then you can solve the equations whatever you will get. And here you will get one more condition also. If M1 equal to M2, you can prove it also. Then alpha beta will become 90 degrees. So they move in right angles after the collision under the condition M1 equal to M2. Try to prove it on your own. Thank you.